Hello and welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to see how to create this mirror effect. Before further proceeding, I would like to thank you for being here and supporting me. And also, if you are new to this channel, please do consider subscribing. That would be highly appreciated. Let's not waste any more of the time. Let's get into Photoshop. I have this image in the layer 1 and I will duplicate it. Create a solid layer. Make sure the solid layer is black in color and move that below the duplicated layer. Select the rectangle marquee tool and create a selection as shown. Right click and click on layer via cut and turn off the visibility of the cut layer. Go to the layer 1 copy and again create a selection and right click and click on layer via cut. Do this for the entire image. Delete the portions where the subject is not present. Now select the layer 5 and select the move tool. Move it to the right end of the canvas. Select the layer 4 and turn on its visibility. Let it be there. Turn on the visibility of the layer 3. Move it to the left side of the layer 4. Turn on the visibility of the layer 2 and move it to the left of layer 3. Try to make equal distance between the layers as possible as you can. Now select all the cut layers and group them. Name it as top. Duplicate the group and rename it to whatever you want. I am renaming it to 1. Select the group 1 and move it below the top group. Convert the group 1 to smart object and go to filter and select blur. In that, choose Gaussian blur. Set the blur radius to 6 and click OK. Now move the group 1 to the left of the canvas so that the top group and the group 1 makes a perfect match to complete the portrait. Duplicate the smart object, move it to furthermore to the left of the canvas and try to match another two cut layers. Now select the two smart objects and group them. I am calling it as bottom. Double click on the bottom group to bring up the layer style and click on color overlay. Set the blending mode to normal. Set the opacity that is applicable to your image. I am setting it to 15%. Now double click on the top group to bring up the layer style and click on bevel and emboss. In that, set the style to outer bevel. Set the technique to chisel hard and the depth to all the way up to 1000 and the size to 10 pixels. In the shading, set the highlight mode to normal and the color to black and the opacity to 100%. Same way in the shadow mode, set the blending mode to normal and the color to black and the opacity to 50%. Create a solid color and make sure that's black in color. Grab the brush tool and choose a brush of much higher softness. Set the brush size to around 1500 and dab it wherever you want the portrait to be highlighted. Create a gradient map. I am choosing a black and white gradient. Create a curves adjustment layer and bring it below the solid color adjustment layer. And change the curves individually for the portrait you have chosen. Tweak for more contrast and you will end up in a good looking image. That's it. Hope you enjoyed this video. Let's see the final output. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and also like, comment and share. And once again, thanks for being here and supporting me. I will see you in the next video. This is Raudhran signing off.